Even before I was born, my story is about football. It begins in 1987 when Jason Dunstall kicked a record 16 goals in one match for Hawthorn. I was in my mum's tummy at the time, and that was when my parents decided that I would be called Jason.
I'm Jason Ball. I'm an advocate for equality and mental health and an aspiring politician. I was about 12 years old when I figured out that I was gay, and at the time I thought that that was the worst possible thing that I could be. Being a gay person in a country town and in a football club, I didn't really feel like I belonged. What could have helped me at that point in my life was a role model. It would have helped me to know that you can have a happy life and a good life as someone who is gay. The Pride Cup was a football match put on by my team in Yarra Glen to celebrate inclusion and diversity for the LGBTI community. And so as part of the day, we had the 50 metre line painted in a rainbow, and we had a rainbow, the international symbol for gay pride, incorporated into the jumpers of both teams who played on the day. And I think what was the most powerful thing about it was that it was a message of acceptance coming from a place where you least expect it, in the country footy world. And I think if country football can be on board with this issue, then it can be okay anywhere. As an ambassador, as an advocate on these issues, I've had some amazing opportunities to go and speak at schools and to speak at sporting clubs and workplaces and all sorts of different settings to share my story, which I guess in one sense is a message of hope for young people who are same-sex attracted or gender diverse. But it's also a way to raise the consciousness of the rest of society as to the impacts that words can have, and homophobia in particular. And I guess probably the most rewarding thing about doing this work has been hearing from young people who have said that hearing my story or seeing it in the news has given them the courage to come out to their own parents or their own family or even their own football team. And it's just the most fulfilling thing. And that was why I guess I wanted to continue to do it, and it's what's driven me today. I became an ambassador for Beyond Blue, which is the National Depression and Anxiety Initiative. And for me, mental health was a really great foundation to the advocacy I was doing around inclusion in sport. Mental health for me, it became something that I wanted to dedicate my life to. It became something that I wanted to make my job. And so I was actually invited to go to Canberra and speak at Parliament House to MPs and senators from all sides of politics to share my story. And when I was talking to them, I really got the sense that, these are the people in society who have the power to change things, who have the power to make society better. And I guess that was a pretty big motivating factor for me to think about my move into politics, and that's something that I would like to do. I think for me, it also gives me an opportunity to talk about other issues that I'm passionate about. It's not just LGBTI inclusion and mental health, but also things like climate change and asylum seeker policy. And these are things that from my university days when I studied politics that I was pretty passionate about. And so I'm looking forward to being able to apply that on a bigger scale. Growing up as a kid in the bush, the environment has always felt like home for me. It's somewhere that I felt safe, it's somewhere that I felt free. It kind of made me want to protect that environment. And I remember as a kid making my mum, when we're walking to school, we would bring bags so we could like pick up rubbish on the side of the road. I think that was the start of, for me, that sense of ownership over and the responsibility that we have to look after the environment that we live in and to make sure it is as good or if not better for the next generation that comes around. And in the short term, I'm just trying to figure out a way to get this campaign up and running in Higgins, which is exciting. The reason why Higgins is going to be such an interesting contest is because it's traditionally been a blue ribbon seat. It's been held by the Liberal Party since its inception. But the demographics in that seat are changing. And I think also as the Liberal Party has been changing, the people in that seat have been frustrated with the direction of that party. I think it comes back to wanting to help others in a way. Everyone has a right to feel safe, respected, loved, and I think that that's something that needs to be expressed throughout society. And that's definitely something that comes personal for me because of my own experiences.